The government has pledged billions for hospital projects across England. At the start of a Conservative Party conference, the plans include a £2.7 billion investment for six hospitals. The government has pledged billions for hospital projects across England. At the start of a Conservative Party conference, the plans include a £2.7 billion investment for six hospitals over 5 years. A new approach to NHS mental health treatment will also be trialled in 12 areas of England, with housing and job support alongside psychological help. NHS providers welcomed the funding but said more was needed to make up for a decade of capital squeeze. The organisation, which represents trusts in England, said the NHS's annual capital spending of around £6 billion needed to double over the next 5 to 10 years to meet its needs. The government says £70 million is also being invested in the mental health pilot areas, with the NHS building more ties with charities and local councils. About 1,000 extra specialist staff will be recruited in 12 pilot sites, with expertise in a range of mental health issues, the government says. State-of-the-art hospitals under plans drawn up by Health Secretary Matt Hancock. The government has said £13 billion will be spent on hospital projects, including entirely new buildings or revamping existing structures to improve facilities. The same pot of money will also be used to develop plans for further projects in the future. Mr. Hancock said the funding would come from taxpayers, rather than PFI contracts whereby private firms fund the cost of building facilities in return. The state makes payments over a stipulated period of time for their use and management. The six hospital trusts to benefit from the £2.7 billion in funding are Whipps Cross Hospital in Leytonstone, East London Epsom and St. Helier Trust, West Hertfordshire Trust, Princess Alexandra Hospital Trust, University Hospitals of Leicester Trust, Leeds Teaching Hospitals Trust. Mr. Hancock told Sky News' Sophie Ridge on Sunday programme that funding for these six trusts was in place so building work could begin straight away. A further 34 hospitals will receive £100 million in initial funding to start developing projects, including Addenbrookes Hospital in Cambridge, the Queen's Medical Centre in Nottingham and the North Manchester General Hospital. The remaining projects, including up to a dozen smaller community hospitals in Dorset, would be completed over the second half of the next decade.